The cargo bridge across the Dnieper River is one of the large-scale projects of the big construction program in Zaporizhzhia, and it is the first object which visited by Prime Minister during his working trip to the region. The installation of the first cables has already started on the bridge. Each side of it relies on 48 steel ropes from 60 to a little more than 200 meters long. Its total cost from the beginning of works is more than $615 million. I hope in 2 years it will be completed.
The second stop during the trip was a visit to the regional clinical hospital. Its reconstruction has also become a part of the big construction program. The Prime Minister inspected the work of the intensive care unit as well as the reconstructed admission department. In addition, a medical, scientific, practical and educational complex for residents of the southeast of Ukraine will be created on the basis of the hospital. The Prime Minister also paid attention to vaccination issues.
It's impossible to overcome the pandemic without vaccination. Therefore, its obligation for each region is to fulfill the assigned tasks for vaccination, to create the appropriate infrastructure, the opportunity to get a jab for as many willing as possible. 95% of those who get sick are unvaccinated. COVID has turned into a pandemic of the unvaccinated.
The Zaporizhzhia nuclear power plant is another object visited by the Prime Minister. The development of nuclear energy is a strategic task for Ukraine, he said, and he emphasized that this year electricity tariffs for Ukrainians will not grow.
The price set by the government by the end of November is 7.96 hryvnias for individuals and 7.42 hryvnias for public utilities. The price is stable. It is an annual tariff, and gas is supplied continuously at these prices. We do not expect any gas or electricity outages.
This week, Denys Shmyhal will continue working trips to the regions. In the near future, he is going to visit Ternopil region in western Ukraine. Reported by Vadim Kramer and Valery Bakus, UATV News.